So this video, we will be discussing about successive differentiation. So let me explain what this means. Say, let us begin with an example. I have y is a function of x. Okay, we usually take it like this. Now, we always differentiate, say, differentiate with respect to x. If I do that, we write this y as dy by dx, right? And we write function as f dash of x. Okay, and we call this as a first derivative. This is a first differentiation. Now, we can actually keep on doing this, right? So we can do differentiate with respect to x again. So if I differentiate this again, then we say it is double derivative. That is d square y by dx square, and that is f double dash of x. That's the second derivative. And you can actually keep on differentiating this again and again and again. And now I want to guess what is going to be the nth differentiation. Now, nth differentiation is going to be what? I'm going to differentiate that n times. So it is dny upon dx raised to n. Now, that's basically an nth differentiation. Or we can write f n times dash. So we just write out fn of x. Now, this is basically called as a successive differentiation, where you want to differentiate it multiple times. Okay, so you can get a question like that, where you want to find out, say, a very higher order differentiation, say 300th differentiation. Now, if that is the case, how do we do this? Okay, and that is what the successive differentiation is about, that we want to find out something like 300th differentiation. Now, to make you understand these things better, I'm going to take one example. So let's take a question now, and this is, let's say, find 300th differentiation. So we're supposed to differentiate it 300 times, okay? Of y is equal to sine of ax plus b. So I've just taken one sample problem. And it's very, very clear that we are not going to differentiate it 300 times, okay? There has to be a smarter way, okay? So, and the solution of this problem, just let me solve so that you know how this works. So let us begin with the solution. We already have y is equal to sine of ax plus b. Let me take that first. And differentiate with respect to x is what I'll do first. And then the derivative is going to be dy by dx. Now in these cases, what we will do is, instead of calling it dy by dx, okay, we usually write this as y1. Okay, y1 simply means the first derivative. So this is y2, that is the second derivative, and this is yn, that is the nth derivative. And successive differentiation, in the nutshell, says you have to find out yn of a problem. So now here also we'll find yn, and then now eventually we'll put n as 300. Just see how it works. But we will begin with the first differentiation. Just see what we get as a first differentiation, y1. So if I differentiate sine, it will become cos, and this is cos of ax plus b. That's a derivative of sine. Okay, and then we have a chain rule. Then the ax plus b, the derivative is going to be a. Okay, that's my first derivative. I found out y1 from this. Now, before we actually go to second derivative, we will try to just make some adjustment, because we are not only finding differentiation, but we are also trying to find the pattern. Now, how I do that? Just see this. Look, we already know a formula. What if I write sine of theta plus pi by 2? Okay, sine of theta plus pi by 2 is nothing but cos theta. We already know this is a standard entity of trigonometry, right? And right now the cos theta we have is a cos of ax plus b. So this is a theta, is it not? All right. So now we're going to use this formula now, and I'll write down cos theta as sine of theta plus pi by 2. Just see what happens now. This will be sine of, this is ax plus b theta plus pi by 2. And then that a will remain as it is over here. So basically, I've again converted cos back into sine, right? Now, I want to differentiate again. Differentiate with respect to x again, okay? So if I differentiate y1 again, now this will become y2. Now that is the second derivative, or d square y by dx square. Now, what is the derivative of sine? The derivative of sine is going to be cos, okay? So this is cos of everything as it is, ax plus b plus pi by 2. I hope you know that. And now we will again use chain rule onto this. So if I use chain rule, I'll differentiate this whole thing. Okay. These are the constants only. The derivative of this whole thing is just going to be a. All right. And then we already had one a. So I hope you understand this will be a square. Now, once again, I got a cos theta. Do you see that here? Now, if you have a cos theta, we can write it as sine of theta plus pi by 2. So let me do that again. So it will be y2. I'm just rewriting this sine theta cos theta as sine of theta plus pi by 2. And theta was this. So it is ax plus b plus pi by 2. This was the theta. Okay. And then to convert cos into sine, we will add one more pi by 2. I am precisely using this formula here. Okay. Nothing more than that. And then this a square is anyways as it is. So we've got this y2. Okay. Now, just to make you understand things better, I'm going to solve differentiate one more time. But I'm sure many people have already guessed it, that when it is second derivative, I'm getting 2 pi by 2s. When it is first derivative, I'm getting 1 pi by 2. Now, we should ideally get 3 pi by 2s when we do third derivative. And I hope you can already see that. So let's just see what happens again. Let me do one more. This is just the first problem. So let's do it completely. So differentiate with respect to x one more time. And then the y2 becomes y3. That is the third derivative. And third derivative, if I differentiate this, the derivative of this thing is going to be cos. And this is ax plus b plus pi by 2 plus pi by 2. Look, this was theta, right? This was theta. So that will all remain as it is. And then the chain rule will give me one more a. And then there is already a square. So this will become a cube. And once again, for y3, I can convert cos theta into sine theta. How do I do that? This is theta, right? So if I want to convert cos theta into sine theta, it is ax plus b plus pi by 2 plus pi by 2. And then we'll add one more pi by 2. Okay, that's how I convert sine into cos. And then there is a cube. Now, after you write like this, all you have to do is you have to find a pattern. And I'm sure you all can see one pattern here, that when this was the first differentiation, there was 1 pi by 2 and a power of a was 1. When there is, this is a second derivative, the number of pi by 2s are 2, and this is second power of a. Then when we are doing the third derivative, okay, we are getting pi by 2 three times, and we are getting a cube. Now, with this trend, we can definitely guess that if it has to be nth differentiation, okay, so let me clear some space first real quick. So now I can say that if we keep on differentiating, the nth derivative or yn is going to be sine of ax plus b. Okay, that term is always there, ax plus b. And then we get pi by 2 plus pi by 2 plus pi by 2. That is going to be n times pi by 2 will be added. That is going to be n pi by 2. I hope you understand this also. And then this is a raised to n. Okay, now this is your nth derivative of the given function. So the final answer is, if you have y as sine of ax plus b, then its nth derivative is going to be sine of ax plus b plus n pi by 2 times a raised to n. Okay, now once we get this y of n as well, we can always find 300th derivative. Now for 300th differentiation, okay, what will we do? We will simply put n is equal to 300, right? We can now put any value over here. So 300th differentiation is going to be sine of ax plus b plus 300 times pi by 2. Of course, you can divide by 2. And then this is a raised to 300. And this is my final answer. So one thing that you have to understand from this solving is that when you want to find out a very high differentiation, like a 300 differentiation, in that case, you start differentiating once and twice and thrice. And while you do that, you have to find a pattern. Okay. So that from that pattern, you can guess what is going to be the nth differentiation is the basic strategy what we employ to find the successive differentiation. So now we will be solving some more problems, and this can be also taken as a standard formula. So it's a derivative of sine of ax plus b. Okay. So we can also remember this as a formula. And the formula is like this, that if you have sine of ax plus b, and if you take the nth differentiation, okay, the answer is going to be sine of ax plus b plus n pi by 2 times a raised to n. And it's very similarly, you can solve the other one, and I leave that one to you for you to solve. This is, if it is cos of ax plus b, and if you decide to find out the nth differentiation here, this will become cos of ax plus b plus n pi by 2 times a raised to n. You can easily prove it. The procedure is almost the same. So I will leave the second part, the cost one, for you to solve on your own. And it's going to be very easy. I hope you followed this.